896, April 19th. Just dropped mom off at the shuttle. She's heading back to New Jersey today. She had a nice 2-week vacation here in Santa Fe, and now I'm just getting organized here at the bottom. About to get all the equipment together here. Sun's gonna come up right here. It took me about 15 minutes to get over here to the triple chair. I'm just gonna keep heading east to the Millennium chair and then start heading up. Make a good time here. The sun hasn't even come up. It's just starting to break through the trees here. Sun is breaking over the mountains right now. It's like you're in a national park over here. It's just below freezing, so I don't know if that's pretty nice conditions here. But it should hit 72 in town today. Alright, we're all the way across to the other side of the mountain, so I'm on the northeast side now. So now it's time to climb, and I'm heading right up over that way to the Nambe Chutes. So it took me about an hour to get to the top of Alpine Mall. So I'm making really good time. You can see I'm heading northeast. And the snow is still pretty hard packed, but anything in the sun is starting to loosen up a little bit. And the skins are holding. So far so good. It's 8:30 and I'm making great time. This sign here would have said Lobo. So I made it to the top of Lobo, and now I'm trying to climb to the top of Camp Robber up this way. In about another hour, I should be at Ravens. So I'm going to make Ravens in an hour. I could be at the top in 3 hours from the bottom. I'll get myself four just in case. Beautiful day. The sun finally is up high in the sky, and the snow is melting a little bit. It's 9 o'clock, and right behind me is the top of Ravens. So about an hour and a half to get this far. Oh, another hour and I'll be in the backcountry. And then I'm supposed to meet this guy Yates. So I'll get him till noon. By then the Nambe Chutes should be all warmed up and ready to go. Those last five climbs must have gotten me in shape because it's 9:20, a little under 2 hours, and I've left the Santa Fe Trail, the Sunset Trail behind me, and I'm on the last pitch. I'm standing at the bottom of Coyote, and I just have this pitch to go to the top, and at the top, then you go left into the woods, and that starts the backcountry, and basically I'm trying to get to the other side of this ridge right here, so it's just up and across, and I'm there. And then a long wait for my buddy, my newfound friend. See if he makes it, otherwise I'll be flying solo. And yesterday we were at Chimayo, so we saw there's just a ton of snow still in the Nambe Chutes, so got another hour to go. Woo! I spy with my little eye the summit. Woo! And the entrance to the backcountry. Wind is really strong up here today. All right, let's do a time check. Let's see. All right, 9:43, so I left at 7:25. So about 2.5 hours to get up right through the woods right there. It takes a couple of minutes to get over there. I'm just going to have lunch here and hang out and wait for any human life. I've seen a lot of tracks coming up, very large animals. Some kind of elk or deer or a bear or something big. Cats, maybe, gigantic. Twice as big as my basket on my ski poles. So huge tracks in the soft snow. Step the Nambe Chutes. Well, Josh, I'm standing on top of your favorite run.
Columbine! Woo! Right through the trees.
I remember that day well. Hey, next time you come up, I'm taking you over to the chutes.
Getting ready to go.
Just waiting to see if Yates shows up. It looks like a good run waiting and soft climbing back up, so it should be good. Woohoo! April the 19th, day 96. Thank you.
Sex shoot, 2 minutes of glory. And now look at the booting back up. Look at all the boot marks. Everybody boots straight back up. Whew. Lake Nambe is somewhere down that way. Whew. What a place. That's Lake Peak. That's one of the highest peaks. Whew. Text from Yates, he was downtown. He said, enjoy your run. And then two girls with their dogs just came by on snowshoes. They're going over Lake Peak. All right, next video will be getting out of this hole. Woo, day 96, what a thrill. I hope there's enough snow for day 100 to be over on this side also. Somebody got way up there in that crack. I can see a trail down there. Not sure how he got his skis on at the top there. Woo! It's melting fast over here. Live from Santa Fe, the Nambe Chutes. Woo! Alright, next season, found a really good way to get get to the top of those trees, there's an entrance right up there, and then there's a track somebody took, a line right across underneath those huge rocks up at the very top. And with enough snow, if you can get over that rock pile there and stay above those big rocks there, you can come out way at the top of the trees. If not, you could come down to the lower part of the trees. But that's a very doable run right there itself. And so are all these big ones right here. Hard work getting out of that hole. Still plenty of skiing way over there. Still plenty of snow in the middle of that thing. Wow. It's hard to believe, dude. 96 is still in progress. Started at about 7:25. I left the parking lot. No idea what time it is now, but I've never wanted to do a blue cruiser so badly in my life. Next to Parachute is the next one over. There's Blizzard, then through Tequila, Sunrise. Then I had to traverse Roadrunner, Fall Line, and now I'm on Northburn, Parachute, and after Parachute will be Gateway. Can't wait to find a cruiser. So that was exhausting. Josh, I know how you must feel after you finish a marathon. Skidding to the top of the Nambe Chutes and skinny down. Top of the quad chairlift right there. And I'm gonna continue traversing over to this side. Well, I made it all the way to Cornice, so this is a day of extremes. I went as far east as I could and then I made shoots to as far west as I could. Okay. This is a Cornice and there's nothing after this except another backcountry run. That goes way, way down. So, ski back to the car. So, come on out if you want to get into any more action. Got plenty of snow.